But first, the hunt for a suspected serial bomber tonight, striking fear yet again in Austin. This time, authorities say with a tripwire bomb, the fourth bomb to go off. The first bomb in a package left at a home. The following week, two more packages on the same day, both exploding. And this newest bomb with that tripwire on a darkened street overnight. The neighborhood on lockdown for most of this day, and tonight the audio of this newest bomb going off just out. ABC's Marcus Moore leading us off from Austin tonight.
Tonight, more than 500 agents flooding Austin, Texas, a massive manhunt intensifying.
We are clearly dealing with what we expect to be a serial bomber at this point.
There's a loud explosion on scene.
8:32 p.m. Sunday night, a bomb exploding, the sound captured on this surveillance video. Seriously injuring two men, the fourth attack in less than 20 days, but this device detonated by a tripwire.
With this tripwire, this changes things. It's more sophisticated. It's not targeted to individuals.
The massive blast site littered with evidence tags. One of the unsuspecting victims walking on this suburban street, tripping a nearly invisible wire connected to a device placed several feet away.
That's what we need is people paying attention for suspicious objects, bags, boxes, backpacks, anything that just looks out of place.
We need to lock down a, like I said, two-block perimeter. There's a nail in the wound of one of the subjects.
Richard Harrington heard the latest blast.
My first thought, that's my granddaughter. Yeah, she could have run down the street and tripped the wire.
The fear of more devices triggering a neighborhood lockdown. School buses kept away. This bomb went off hours ago, and authorities still have this neighborhood street closed, and they're urging residents to stay in their homes for their safety. Teams of investigators combing through the streets, searching for clues that could lead them to the bomber. David asking the police chief on Good Morning America.
Do you have any suspects, any names, any potential people you're looking at?
We've had a lot of good leads and tips come in, and we run each one of those to ground. At this point, we have people that we have looked at, but there's no leading suspect at this time.
Baffled authorities not ruling out any motive, including a hate crime, even though the latest victims were white. The previous three blasts, all package bombs, killing two. Those victims, all minorities. Desperate for any answers, police now asking the bomber to contact them.
What kind of a person would do this?
That's what we're trying to figure out, and that's one of the reasons why we would like the bomber to reach out and talk to us.
Marcus Moore with us live tonight from the scene of that fourth blast. And Marcus, authorities pleading with the public now to check their own home surveillance cameras should they have one.
That's right, David. The thinking here is that someone has surveillance video that could help police crack this case. And investigators are also working to reconstruct the latest device, hoping to identify a unique part of the bomb that could link them directly to the suspect, David.
Marcus Moore leading us off tonight.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.